Since time began, man has been fascinated with evil. Artists have shown us its face.
You'll be needing your torch now.
Evil has been personified as Satan, Beelzebub, Lucifer. Sometimes the devil is a man. Sometimes a woman. And sometimes only a mindless power. Evil is usually seen as something monstrous. But not always.
Look.
The idea of a devil who is attractive,
is him,
even innocent, was the premise for the highly successful motion picture, The Omen, in which the devil takes the form of a young boy, Damien. Now, in The Omen Part 2, the boy has grown older, and the story has moved from the world of international diplomacy to the corporate world of America. Here, his stepfather, Richard Thorne, moves unsuspectingly with his family.
All set?
I'll be right back.
Through a life of luxury and privilege.
What you're saying is that we should give up our leadership in electronics.
Richard Thorne, played by William Holden, is chairman of the board of the powerful Thorne Industries and a famous collector of art.
Kazarian, hold it here.
Appropriately, William Holden is himself an art collector. In his case, a superb collection of primitive art from Africa and the South Pacific.
There are certain symbols in their art that are created to ward off what might be a malevolent spirit that would influence their tribal life. They constantly live with ghosts and the fear of ghosts, but then again, I can't think of a race of people on Earth that aren't, to a degree, superstitious.
In primitive art, evil is always grotesque.
I'll see you next summer, Jim.
Say goodbye to your cousin for me, Damien.
I will.
But today, in a world grown weary, it must be disguised. It is Damien's attractiveness that prevents his father from suspecting him.
He, in relationship to the story that's being told, is a complete innocent.
You are in grave danger!
What's the matter, Thor? Did you whack it on your back?
Teddy?
Another Thor.
Oh, please, please, you must listen to me!
Thorne and his family find their serenity shaken. Gradually, their suspicions will become undeniable.
Terrible thing to imagine. You as the devil is unbelievable. And he tries to run away from the thought of it.
What did you do to him? I don't know.
He's just trying to run away from the thought, trying to shut it out of his mind. And it's a thought of, you know, why me?
For one important sequence, the company moves to a frozen lake in upper Wisconsin. Even for experts, the sequence will be unusually dangerous.
Well, here today at 15 below zero, we're going to go under the ice with one of our actors, and then we're going to have the stuntmen double them. It's about 45 seconds without a wetsuit or proper equipment that you could last in this water. I mean, you're on about 6 inches of ice, but if we all went through, that would be it.
Take your places! See,
camera mark!
See, camera mark!
I can't!
Hold on, Bill!
Bill!
Oh, my God, it's gone!
Let's go!
Get under the ice!
Don't
Mr. Thorne!
Okay. Quiet!
Although both the omen and its successor have their share of dramatic and exciting scenes,
around here to him.
All right, so we need all of those.
Their real power comes from the credibility of the familiar.
Look at him. Now, back to your cake.
The time is coming for you to put aside childish things and face up to who you are. A great moment, Damien. Surely you must be feeling it.
I think so. I'm not sure. But I feel that something's happening to me. It's going to happen.
Suspicions of destiny. We all have them. A deep, wordless knowledge that our time has come.
I know who you are.
Say it, Mark.
He said you're the beast.
Come on.
A jackal! You're born of a jackal!
Born in the image of the greatest power in the world. The desolate one.
But he has risen, Mark. In me.
I can take you with me.
Damien, The Omen, Part 2. A story of evil, coming of age, in an unsuspecting world.